true amateur standout, Julius Creed.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the Creed Brothers from Lexington, Ohio, weighing in at 230 pounds, Julius Creed.
Championships and accolades as a collegiate wrestler and his continued.
Madrid, Spain, weighing in at
3, former All-American collegiate wrestler will start us off. True shades of some past WWE greats, wouldn't you say?
True. It's hard not to see other amateur wrestlers in Creed's game, but his ceiling might be even higher. He's truly a once-in-a-lifetime athlete. He's taken to this business like few people I have ever seen.
High praise indeed. We'll see if he lives up to it.
And he'll be taking on the superhero known as Axiom. For what he lacks in size, he more than makes up for in brains.
He's a nerd, Saxton. That's why you like him. You two probably sat at the same table during lunch.
Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here. Great strength being shown here. Oh, my goodness.
Uh-oh. Just toss their opponent.
It might not be flashy, but sometimes you just gotta toss another person to make a statement.
And now thrown back into the ring.
There's some power behind that punch. Look at this.
Oh, from the rope.
Expected that one. Big impact.
Axiom had a solution for that problem.
Great athleticism from Creed.
Julius Creed is a very formidable young competitor who doesn't seem to have too many weaknesses in his game, wouldn't you say, Corey?
Well, in terms of natural skill, he's got it all. But most of Julius's professional experience has been in a tag team. That leaves a lot of room to capitalize on his inexperience as a solo competitor. There's a narrow path to victory there, but it's there.
Ruthless chop block. His shoulders are down! And he manages to kick out in one.
He couldn't make much of that pin attempt.
Put into position now.
Julius Creed letting him know he's ready for anything he's got. Whoa, not quite yet. Effective arm drag.
Some of his win now.
Nice takedown.
Prying their opponent's arm up.
There's a double stop right down on the arm.
And he's able to counter.
To the arm.
Hyper extend your elbow.
The WWE Universe giving him an extra shot of adrenaline.
Oh, connected with these knee strikes. Oh, ouch.
We're gonna see it.
Gut-wrench power bomb. Does he get him here? Digging deep for a kick out.
So close. That could have been it.
Oh, man.
Right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow. Just stretch it out the arm. Tucks under.
Pele kick.
He's got him. Getting ready. Dismantling the arm in the corner. Gotta hurt. Pinpointing the leg in the corner. Axiom reverses.
The superstar building incredible momentum.
Oh, I mean, this is, I don't know how the superstar's doing it.
Down and out moments ago. Back in it now.
His opponent's artillery.
Cover! Two count!
Oh, and he just kicked out.
This man can withstand anything. Just survived a page torn from his own playbook.
I thought
Axiom finds the golden ratio.
Axiom might have him. Looking for the victory. There's two.
Finally ends it. And all the bloodshed. Perhaps worth it now.
Here is your winner, Axiom.
This is the type of victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
With a win like this, things have got to taste a little bittersweet
right about now.
Actually, here comes the Pride Fighter.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4. Making her way to the ring from Shamong, New Jersey, Sonya Deville.
Well, if you look up power hungry in the dictionary, I'm pretty sure you'll see Sonya Deville's picture.
Blair Davenport, a young woman who won't let any competitor get in her way. She does whatever she wants to do.
A world-traveled competitor looking to make her mark in WWE.
And from Wellington, New Zealand, Blair Davenport.
Always looking to make a statement of superiority and viciousness.
Exerted her dominance as one of the top women in NXT UK and is now looking to take the...
We'll start with Sonya Deville, who has really proven herself to be one of the more cunning superstars here in WWE.
A woman after my own heart, Cole. Her ambition knows no bounds. She'll backstab anyone she has to, and she's got hands for anyone who crosses her. You have to respect it.
I don't know about that, but you certainly have to tread lightly around her.
But we have to turn our attention to Blair Davenport, who competed all over the world before finally setting her sights on WWE domination. She's not just here to take over the women's division. She wants to strike fear in the heart of anyone foolish enough to challenge her.
According to Davenport, she has the wicked willingness to do whatever it takes to accomplish those goals. But in my opinion, all of this just makes her the scourge of the women's division.
Davenport's plans for division domination clearly being challenged with that.
Heavy hands from the cunning Sonya Deville.
Boom! So, Corey, what can Sonya Deville do to ensure she comes out on top in this matchup?
Sonya needs to utilize her MMA background.
From the top!
Elbow drop!
Climbing up to the top now.
Oh, look out!
Uh-oh. Oh, she lands hard.
Stalking a downed opponent in a vicious boot and a boot in the face.
Putting a stop to all her showboating.
A springboard attack. She can do it here. Fends off the three count.
She is still fighting, still keeping this going. As the arm bar stretch in. Punishing stretch.
Can't lift anyone at that.
Quickly, the cover. She breaks the count quick.
I think this match still has a ways to go.
Sonya Deville, series of kicks.
Followed by a net. She could pin her opponent right here. Almost 2.5.
Wow.
Sonya Deville, and then the elbow drop.
Sonya can be looking to end this.
The cover! And that'll about do it, folks.
Here is your winner, Sonya Deville.
This was as dominant a win as I've ever seen, guys.
That's why they call it light work, Cole. Barely even broke a sweat.
Make way for the It Couple.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Maurice from Hollywood, California, weighing in at 221 pounds, The Miz.
These two are such a wonderful couple because they have so much in common. Title reigns.
Saxton.
And his opponent, accompanied by Xavier Woods, representing the New Day from Ghana, West Africa. Wait.
Some people might see The Miz as a brazen loudmouth, but there's no question how Miz sees himself. He thinks he's awesome, and throughout his highly successful career, he's pretty much proven that claim to be true.
Well, The Miz might just have the biggest ego in the history of this industry, and that's saying something, but you're right. There's no denying that he's backed up all of his arrogant claims by being a talented competitor.
And now The Miz is ready to once again show the entire WWE Universe just how awesome he can be.
And then you have Kofi Kingston, who can definitely be grating at times with all that power and positivity stuff, but is absolutely undeniable when the bell rings.
High energy, explosive offense. Kingston never lets up and never slows down.
Referee in position.
Way too soon for him to be thinking about a pin.
Solid contact from The Miz. Momentum has shifted towards The Miz.
And the WWE Universe is being demoralized by Kofi's situation.
And that explosive style of Kingston got dampened a bit there.
Tell it like it is. The Miz dished out some pretty awesome offense there.
Ooh, bullseye.
Cover, cover. Kick out before three.
That was a long two count there. Get back here. Leg lariat. Sometimes you just gotta show off and show out.
Into the corner he goes. A perfectly placed target. It's a distinct weakness of his that you would target.
I personally don't see it. Some say Miz has too much pride, so I try to get under his skin. If you can get inside the Miz's head and push him up.
Incoming!
Through the air! And connects!
Showing absolutely no apprehension to putting one's body on the line.
Drop kick right on point. And Miz now finding himself on the wrong side of momentum.
Maybe trying to damage Miz's pride as much as his body with these attacks. The Miz looking off balance mentally here.
Ooh, neck breaker.
Measured stomp right to the gut. Oh, and in the chest as well.
Look out!
He misses the target.
Short flight, but a rough landing.
Russian leg sweep.
The better part of valor. Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring.
Uh-oh. Jawbreaker! Call the dentist.
Slam.
And Kofi knows it is game time right now.
Measured knee drop.
And it looks like the Miz has a nasty gash on his head.
Couple of hard shots.
Count out may be imminent here.
Really testing fate right now.
To the outside.
This could get wild.
What reflexes to stop Kofi?
Okay, he is not going to let him make a mockery of things.
Spinning kick to the gut.
Textbook jumping clothesline. Oof.
Great flurry of offense from Kofi.
You cannot deny Kofi Kingston right now.
And the possibility for serious injury just went way up.
These superstars are starting to get very imaginative right now. You have to think someone's looking at that stage and getting some dark thoughts.
The Miz letting him know who the real star attraction is here.
Maybe that will shut him up.
He can end it here.
He's got it.
Way he is still in this.
Hooked up.
Great power.
Inverted suplex. He's running on empty.
Thanks for coming, Miz. Shoulders down.
For him in this match.
Kofi wins! Kofi wins because New Day rocks! New Day rocks!
Sit down, Saxton.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 259 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP!
Well, from humble beginning... Here comes the original bro.
Yeah, and here comes the original Scooter.
And his opponent from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 216 pounds, the original bro, Matt Riddle.
Sometimes a worry for NXT stars. Can they make the jump to the main roster? Riddle's been at home in WWE. Riddle out here, set for competition. Guys, we say it time and time again. Uh-oh. Crossface!
Can you imagine what it would do to him?
And rolls him off.
What a counter by Riddle. One step ahead of Riddle there. Gets thrown head over heels by the Exploder. Getting set up for something in the corner. Punch right to the face.
Punch connects.
Reversal. Can he take advantage?
Right across the face.
Push it all the way up.
Brainbuster.
Gonna turn your cranium inside out with that.
From the top. Oh, misses the mark.
Oof. He gets what he deserves for all that gloating.
If you had to go up against an experienced superstar like MVP, what would your strategy be?
Well, as you mentioned, MVP has a ton of
That can't be enough, can it? It bypasses the pinfall.
Gotta do more to get the fall.
Some damage already.
He planned for this and could still rally.
How humiliating. Just kicks to the face. Riddle with a reversal.
Whoa, leaping through the air.
And he goes for the pin. Kick out at one.
Showing his determination there with that kick out.
Oh, striking with an A.
Stops the incoming attack with a knee to the face.
He's stuck now.
Powerful suplex toss.
Whoa. Was definitely not thinking about finesse with that one. Was only thinking about dominance.
Gut wrench suplex.
Stepping things up a little bit. The superstar starting to build.
Blow after blow.
High level of offense on display from Riddle.
This is a good strategy against the veteran MVP. Wearing him out and making him a target.
Bro, Derek.
Riddle with nothing but straight savagery.
Riddle proving just how serious of a competitor he really is.
Riddle not playing games anymore. Measuring him up.
Big kick from Riddle connects. Now, raining down. Looking for the bro mission.
The bro mission is locked in.
Oh, just tap out. Just tap out and end this thing.
Losing this match would absolutely destroy him. He's trying to fight it the best he can.
Trying to find a way out. Several right hands and he's out.
See here.
Oh, bro to sleep.
Into the giant suplex.
Here is your winner, the original bro, Matt Riddle.
He really wanted this one bad.
Yeah, what a major win for him here.
No doubt about it, support for this guy grows by the second in the estimation of the WWE Universe. Took my spot here at the commentary table. I have wanted to call this match. I cannot wait.
One thing we know for sure about Johnny Gargano is that there is no quitting him. A superstar who relentlessly chases his dreams and always finds a way to keep himself motivated.
Yeah, he is one stubborn individual. But I'll admit, it takes a ton of tenacity to put together a career like Johnny's. He has that in ample supply.
That willingness to never give up could give Johnny the edge once again here.
And then there's the Ultimate Warrior. As wild and unpredictable as he is powerful. Actually, probably more so. Throw in his nonstop intensity, and good luck trying to get past him when he's across the ring from you.
The line has been drawn, the war paint is on, and the Warrior is breathing in the ashes of the battlefield.
Neckbreaker! Sharp jab. Series of strikes to the back. He goes for the quick pin. And a good strong kick out there.
This one isn't going to be ended quite so easily.
Time and time again, we've seen that there is no keeping Gargano down. How do you counter Johnny Wrestling's incredible stamina?
It's true, Gargano doesn't know when to quit. So the best you can do is pile on as much damage as possible. Overwhelming force is the only way you might be able to keep Gargano down.
Oh, what a clothesline.
Forcefully delivered.
Able to elude it. Had the Ultimate Warrior scouted. Nice half kick, great elevation. And that intense style of Warrior taking a bit of a downturn there.
A tenacious Johnny looking as determined as ever.
Gargano showing his alertness there.
Whatever's playing here can't be good.
To land, but that might be the hardest.
Warrior showing no fear up there.
Soaring. Good Lord. Taking flight.
You want to talk about putting it all on the line.
Always an extra risk when you dive ringside. Oh, what a clubbing blow. Driven into the barricade.
Gargano's been busted open.
Gargano is fighting himself at a disadvantage.
What a show of overwhelming force trying to pile on the damage and nullify Gargano's incredible stamina.
There are plenty of ways battling in this area could end in serious harm. What are you guys thinking?
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
Denied and reversed into a DDT.
Heads out of the ring. What's next? Thrown back in under the ropes. He takes control.
Gargano trying to bring the fight back in this one.
And sent right into the corner. Gargano has him up. Johnny with a little power of his own.
Oh, and the cover for the win.
This is it. Warrior just barely gets the shoulder up.
He kicked out. He actually kicked out.
It up.
Oh, gutbuster!
Evisceration.
And here he goes for the win!
Can he close it out? Forces the shoulder up after two.
I didn't think we'd see a kick out there.
Oh, man, a little extra luster behind that kick.
Producing a trampling.
Heading up, he's thinking back.
Elbow.
What a counter by Gargano.
Well, there may be no escape.
It's locked in. Gargano, escape is locked in. It's locked in, Byron. It's locked in. He may tap out. He may tap.
Oh, no. This is not where he wants to.
Oh, he's able to find enough grip to fight out of the hole. Crucial escape here. Right into the corner. Yeah.
Gargano! Oh, long time for the turnbuckle.
The electricity has been cut. The Warrior slow to a stop.
Ooh, just turned that around. You've got to wonder how much has been taken out of these superstars thus far.
And he's able to move up.
Dialed in on Johnny.
Position here. I agree, it was quite the display tonight.
The strength.
Guys, I have it on good authority that the Tiffany Stratton action figure is about to take the place of that other doll everyone played with growing up.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring. From Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton.
We are about to see a martial arts masterpiece, both on the ramp and in the ring.
Chongqing, China, Xia Li.
Oh, Xia has an impressive martial arts background.
Xia is certainly well-versed in the art of combat. The protector has arrived.
Daddy's little princess, Tiffany Stratton, looking to prove that she has it all.
Brawn, beauty, brains. Yeah, Cole, I'd say she's got it all. And those are things her daddy didn't even need to buy her.
We'll have to see if Stratton can cash those checks her mouth already wrote.
And with Xia Li, you have a competitor who believes she's on a righteous path of justice, one lethal offensive maneuver at a time.
Never backing down, standing up for what she believes in. That makes Li a very dangerous superstar.
Away. Oh, looking to cripple the leg. Yes, snap suplex. Finds a counter for Li. Nailing clothesline.
And she heads to the floor to think of her next move.
Time for some deep breaths.
Corey, there's no lack of confidence when it comes to Tiffany Stratton. How can her opponent shake that out of the Buck Beauty?
Well, Tiffany certainly is a physical specimen. We've definitely seen her tantrums get the better of her. If you can control the match and set the pace, that'll surely frustrate her. And it's hard to be confident when you're frustrated, Corey.
Drop. It's effective.
Ah, look at this. Hair pulled in that slam. Great counter.
And Stratton's just rubbing it in her opponent's face now. I respect it.
Eight. She was a millisecond away from a count out, guys.
Wrapping the arm over that top rope.
Attacking the arm.
Trying to take away that grip, that range of motion on that end.
Oh, boom.
Tiffany Stratton showing off for the audience.
Won't be one to back down either.
Tiffany displaying some of her own brawl.
From the top.
You gotta be kidding me. Taken out from high above. You gotta be some special kind of crazy to do that.
Back of the neck getting worked over.
Battling at ringside can be very unforgiving. You have to be careful out there.
No protection out here. No safe confines to speak of.
And now she delivers her back into the ring.
Tiffany Stratton showing off for the audience.
Shot right to the kidney. Oh. And again.
Great way to wear down your opponent.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
Nasty stomp of the arm. This match is wearing her down.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some.
Here's a cover. And she's not done yet.
She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on.
Take her head clean off her shoulders. She scores big with the counter.
And another counter. One response after another. Back and forth we go.
Here comes that rolling fireman's carry.
Nice rolling fireman's carry.
Stratton hit pay dirt with that move.
Putting her money where her mouth is.
Placing them into the corner.
If you can get past the good looks, pay attention to the athleticism.
Corkscrew Stratton bomb. Stratton is just about to finish this.
And a win here tonight. That'll change your career.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton.
What a moment for her to earn this victory.
Yeah, she got a huge win here.
This win is going to have them on a high for quite some time. I have...
Veni, Vidi, Vici.
The following contest is a triple threat match. Making his way to the ring, representing Imperium. From South Tyrol, Italy, weighing in at 220 pounds, Giovanni Vinci!
Giovanni Vinci, a man who brings even more style and class to Imperium. Time tag champion and a king of the ring.
And representing the New Day from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 205 pounds.
Triple threat bout here with Giovanni Vinci, Hogan, and Xavier Woods.
Always a feeling out process in the early goings of a triple threat. You want to gauge your distance. You want to know just how much real estate you can have to yourself. You don't want to be the first one targeted because things can snowball against you quickly.
In a matchup like this, Corey, what is something the competitors need to remember?
Well, a major difference in a triple threat is that you can lose a match without being part of the decision. Victory can be stolen from your hands in an instant. And that's why, in this match, a competitor must be cunning, calculated, and move with silent speed. Tremendous amount of cardio and strength.
And what's he looking for here?
And now with the kendo stick in hand, he's ready to do some real damage.
And that was taking the attack to the competition with that one.
Ooh!
And these attacks are spelling nothing but trouble.
Wow, what a strike to the back.
Into the corner. This can't be good.
Attack from behind.
Neckbreaker.
Nothing fancy here. Backbreaker. Backbreaker.
Snap power slam.
Neckbreaker.
Tucks his tail between his legs and gets out of there.
Look at this strength.
Big power slam. He's taking some good hits. And able to counter.
Uh-oh. The mouth is mightier than the sword for Xavier Woods.
Hits him with the counter. Oh! He's doing a whole lot of gesturing, and it could cost him.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three.
We could be here all day.
Power.
But
think you're right.
Throws the opposition back into the ring.
Uh-oh.
Harlem sidekick. The crowd is fully behind Xavier Woods right now. This is when Woods becomes dangerous, when he can feed off this arena's positivity.
Boom.
Just a dominant display.
Incredible power slam.
Whip back into the ring.
Nice side headlock applied.
Oh, good measure. He's struggling a bit here.
It's expected, Cole. In a triple threat match, the target on your back is twice the size.
DDT! Xavier Woods turning to some mind games here.
Spine buster.
Could lead to a big time win.
A kendo stick wrapped around the head.
And Xavier reverses.
The Hulkster continues to survive.
Right to the kidneys from behind.
Xavier Woods connected with a good shot there, and he gets set back into the ring.
And just like that, maneuvers out of position.
Ooh, that hurt right in the kidney.
Golly.
If this lands, it might be all over. Death Valley driver by Vinci.
Vinci stamping an end to this.
Cover.
Got it. Survived the triple threat match.
Here is your winner, Giovanni Vinci.
Tremendous victory in this triple threat match.
I cannot even imagine how any of these men feel after a match like that.
All I can really say is that they put on a triple threat match for the...
Get ready for a new normal.
And his opponent from Franklinville, New Jersey, weighing in at 249 pounds, Joe Gacy.
An unsettling arm surrounds Gacy. He calls it a safe place.
Huh. It feels like anything but a safe place, Michael.
The calculating, nihilistic Joe Gacy, ready for action here tonight.
Come on, Cole. Calculating? Nihilistic? Those are just words used to discredit an absolute master.
Penny predicament, shoulders down.
Really overzealous going with a pin attempt there.
Vicious right forearm.
Saw that?
Snap man right
stretch.
Will he needs to find an escape route. Nice. Big flying forearm.
What's the best strategy when going head-to-head with a guy like Robert Roode, who knows every dirty trick in the book?
Well, I think Robert Roode actually helped write that book, Cole. When facing Roode, you need to play it safe and wait for a...
It's nothing he hasn't been through before.
Robert Roode is full of confidence now, and he's letting the WWE fans know it.
Effectively using the knee.
He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
From the top!
Are you kidding me? And shoulders are down.
Two!
And he kicks out at two.
Very close. Fatigue clearly setting in.
Turning the tables.
Ooh. A backbreaker.
Ouch.
What a combo.
Using the elbow as a weapon. And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside. Brought back into the ring from the floor now. This one is headed outside, guys.
Boom! Scorpion death drop.
Ooh. Look at him. Pride and poise personified.
Snapmare.
Oh, and the rolling neck snap.
Setting up.
Suplex!
And he slides him back to the mat.
Clothesline!
They are fading off the WWE fans, now pinning the arm down and...
Goodness gracious.
Putting the boots to an opponent will take the fight up.
And now he's looking to lock in this submission.
Exhibiting a crazy amount of strength here.
Submission locked in tight, nowhere to go.
And he escapes the submission before things got more disastrous for him.
Yes.
The Glorious Robert Roode!